This, if we calculate, this comes out to be 39.25 ohms. 39.25 ohms. This is the value of the inductive reactance. Now, I need to calculate the value of RMS current. That is nothing but RMS voltage divided by the reactance of the inductor. RMS voltage is given how much? It is 220 volts divided by 39.25 ohms. If I calculate this, this comes out to be 5.6 amperes. Is the RMS value of the current. Now, if you want to calculate what is the maximum current that it can allow, that is nothing but IRMS into root 2, you can use this, that is 5.6 into 1.414. This value, whatever it comes, you can just write it as the value which is in terms of amperes. Therefore, maximum current will be IRMS into root 2 will give you the maximum value of the current of the circuit. Right, so based on inductor also I have done this problem. So wherever the value of the inductance, frequency, RMS are given, we can just first calculate the inductive reactance, then RMS current is nothing but voltage upon reactance, and then maximum value is equal to RMS current into root 2. So we can have another problem. The problem is, it is given, find the current that will flow through a coil of negligible reactance, resistance and inductance of 60 millihenries. When connected to 230 volts, that means voltage is given, VRMS is 230 volts and frequency F is given as 50 hertz. Right? Another problem I am taking out, this is single phase power supply, and in this one the reactance value, now inductance value is given as 60 millihenries. And negligible resistance, that means there is no resistance, that means it is a purely pure inductor. What will be the current if the frequency is, okay, now let us calculate the XL value here, 2 pi FL, that is 6.28 into F is 50 hertz into L is 60 millihenry, 60 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So this comes out to be around 18.86 ohms. This will be the value of the inductance. So therefore, the value of RMS current is VRMS upon XL, and that comes out to be 230 volts or 220 volts, anyway you can take it as 18.86. This is 12.2 amperes of the current that flows. Very simple problem. You calculate the XL value and RMS value. But what is the thing here is, in this one, this another important part of this one is, when frequency changes, what will be the effect on this current? So if frequency is increased, if frequency is decreased to 20 hertz, that means in the beginning it was 50 hertz, now it is reduced to 20 hertz. In this case, what happens? So now frequency is taken as 20 hertz, and if we calculate the XL value, this value comes out to be same thing, you can use the formula, 6.28 into 20 in place of this into 60 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Right? So if you calculate this, this comes out to be 7.543 ohms. This is the value of the reactance. That means what is happening? When the, since the inductive reactance is directly proportional to the frequency, as frequency is decreasing, reactance also has to decrease. Therefore, the reactance is decreased. So when reactance decreases here, what happens in this equation for the current? Since the denominator is decreased here, the value of current will increase. Therefore, the value of the current IRMS here will be 230 volts divided by 7.543 ohms will give us 30.49 amperes. So earlier current was only 12.2 amperes, now it is 30.4 amperes. Therefore, when frequency decreases in a AC circuit containing inductor, the amount of current will increase because the reactance will decrease. And the third part of the circuit is basically, when frequency is increased to 60 hertz, in the original circuit it was 50 hertz, and later frequency is decreased to 20 hertz, and now The third case is frequency is increased to 60 Hz. In this case, the reactance value will be increasing because it is directly proportional. The XL value comes out to be 22.63 ohms, and therefore the value of current will be 10.16 amperes. Now, this particular example I have taken basically to tell you about this, what is the effect of frequency on the current and reactance. So, here in case of the inductor circuit where the frequency is decreasing, the current is increasing and the reactance is decreasing. And in case if the frequency is increasing, the reactance is increasing because it is directly proportional, therefore the current is decreasing. So, with normal frequency is 12.2 amperes and with decreased frequency it is 30.94 amperes. And with increased frequency, the current is 10.16 amperes, which is less than the standard value. So, therefore, the effect of frequency also is clear from this example. Okay, thank you.